All right, guys, good morning, good evening, good afternoon. How is everybody? All right, we've got quite a bit of people in here. Okay, we've got 40 people in here right now, and looks like people will start coming in as we get the ball rolling here. Now, let's take a look at what we're going to do today. Today, we're going to discuss a little bit about market profile and a strategy how I personally would think is beneficial to use around this area. Now, as you all know, that market profile, there's many ways. Obviously, I got a comment on YouTube on my previous video of market profile that I wasn't able to convey the message of market profile properly, and I apologize for that if I did make any mistakes on that. So, to begin with, we're not going to get into market profile itself as I am not able to explain it as the professionals do on this. So, what we're going to do is I'm going to get into straight into the strategy of how the strategy can be used using market profile. So we'll jump right into it right now. We're going to spend the next hour over this. Probably half of it is going to be going through some examples, and then the other half we're going to make it a little bit interactive, where we're going to have you guys be involved in seeing how this all of this stuff works. So before we begin, anyone new here in the webinar today? Anyone? Is this anyone's first time? Brian, what time is it there in New Zealand, Brian? Okay, Riaz, you're new. Pedja, first time. Cabello, first time. Julius, Julius, first time. Okay, great, great. So we got quite a few people. Juan and Job. Okay. All right, so let's begin here. If there is any issues with the sound, I apologize for that. If everyone's having issue with sound, let me know, and then I'll see if I can do something. But for now, we should be good. Let's get started. Now, let's take a look. Now, one of the main things we were discussing on market profile is market profile basically measures the strength of the movements in the market that's basically going on, right? And these bars basically build up as there's more and more activity around this area. And as you can see, some areas have less activity than others. You know, for example, this area. Yes, EZE, we're gonna have this also on YouTube. It'll be in YouTube in 24 hours, so don't worry. And if you're watching this on YouTube, please do like the video, comment, and share with your loved ones. So, all right, let's get started here. Now, if you see here, the main aspects of it is we want to catch the areas of the lowest activity areas. The lowest activity areas is the area where the market tends to react from. Okay, this usually is a strong support resistance area or stuff like that. Now, when the day starts, obviously it starts out low and then it starts building up accordingly. Now, when you get a low area, good morning, Vadilvan. When we begin the day, you get these low areas, and you want to look out for a certain time when a low area is formed, and you want to check, is this the area that I want to actually take a trade? How do you do that? Okay, what we need to do is MP alone is technically useless to just use it alone. I'm gonna explain to you guys one particular way that I use. I've taught this little technique today to the conference room members over at Forex Watchers today. Oh, by the way, I hope all of you guys like the new look for forexwatchers.com, and we really have opened it up to the entire public now, and it is available to all. The forecasts are no longer available for $1,000. It's available to all for free. Going back to MP, now let's see here. Okay, how many of you guys actually know divergence, convergence, confluence, and all of that stuff? Okay, I do a little bit, I do, no idea. negative, little. Okay. We're gonna go over this concept a little bit. Now, now divergence, convergence, confluence. This is something I've learned back in the day, you know, like if it's this Riaz, this is called MP. For those of you who do not have this indicator, let me, before I begin, let's show you where you can get the indicator. The indicator link is going to be obviously in the description below this YouTube video. Also, it's also going to be on our website. When you actually go to urbanforex.com, you will see a group that is called Market Profile. And once you click on Market Profile for that group, you will see the link is right there. Market Profile Indicator. And then we have a little presentation and some videos in here as well. So, all right. So, now, the convergence, divergence, confluence. I'm not going to get into what is what. I'm just going to show you how it's used. And what I personally like to use convergence, divergence is stochastics. Okay. How you get stochastics on your screen is you go to Insert, Indicators, and oscillators. Okay, when you go here, you'll see stochastics in your list here. It's over here. I choose the standard settings at K period 5, slowing 3, and percentage D at 3. Just click OK. And I have this little nice thing that's on my screen. Okay, now the next thing you want to do is one of these things. How do you use this to your benefit? Now, take a look at this. You see how the market went from here to here? It created lower lows, right? It had a low here, and then it made another low. You know, it swinged up and came down, but it overall made a low to another low, right? If you actually check your indicator, it's done the same thing. It created a low to a low. You know, it's done pretty much the same thing. When the markets do something totally opposite, you have an indication that the markets will turn. It's going to change. You're going to have a change in direction. Yeah? Now, let me give you an example here. Let's find you a nice example. All right. Here. Let's take a look at, for example, this one here. Okay, the markets are going up, creates a high, comes down, and then it goes up again, creates a higher high. If you draw this to here, you have a higher high. Do we have that same information here on our indicator? No. It actually went lower. Right? Everyone see that? How it's telling you the complete opposite scenario. Okay? When you have a scenario when you have opposite things where the price is telling you one thing and the indicator is telling you one thing, you have a shift in direction of the market, okay? Which means now the market, it was going long, now it's going to turn around from that direction. So if you're checking out the longs, you're going to draw your highs. If you're checking out the lows, you're going to draw the lows. Of course, these rules that I'm telling you may go against some of the rules that the traditional books tell you, but I really don't care about the traditional books. I go with what I see, as you guys have already noticed. So in this particular concept, the price is going higher here and the indicator is going lower here. Hi, Tom. And this is where the market actually turns around. Now, how can we use this to our advantage? Now, first things first, we already see that MP is starting to build up a low over here. Now, we have this additional confirmation that we also have a divergence. You know, we're going to just call this an opposite. Okay? We have an opposite thing happening right here from the price and your indicator, giving you a heads up that the market wants to turn. And this is where you see the market actually turns around. We'll get into more examples of this opposite stuff. And then we'll get into a complete trading plan where would you enter, where would you keep your stops, and where would you exit, and stuff like that accordingly. But let's go one by one. All right. Now, moving forward, let's check out another example for you so we get an idea. Let's see. How about this one here? Let's take a look at this. Now, the market comes down here, creates a low. Then it goes up, and then it starts to come down again, creating a low. Now, if I put my line right here on this low, and I do the same thing on my indicator, I put a line right here. The market goes up, then it comes down, but it never breaches this line. In our indicator, the market goes up, comes down, and it goes way beyond. It breaches this this line that we had drawn like tremendously. When does a breach begin? It begins right here. If I put my mouse directly upwards, the breach begins right here, where you see this candle being formed. Okay, this is the initial area where the breach happens. I think I'm better off drawing an arrow. Okay, around this area, the initial breach takes place. And you're wondering, okay, from this area where the breach happened on the indicator, but not on the price, how far is the price? The price is a good 83 pips away on Euro USD, 83 pips away. It's not easy to make 83 pips come there within one or two candles. I mean, okay, it is easy sometimes when you have candles like this, but the chances are slim because these are saying totally opposite things. Since the market was going down when this happened, we want to connect our lows. We connect our low from here to our recent low, whichever one it may be, and we do the same for over here. And you see the market and the indicators are saying totally opposite things. Okay, market wants to go long, and the indicator is telling you it's going short. You know, somebody's lying here. Doesn't matter. The fact is that as the market's going down and we have this little opposite things happening, shift in the change of direction. Okay, the direction is now approaching a shift. Now, while this shift is changing, obviously you want to see your low bars and pick up the trade. Okay, what is this low bar area? Well, what do you know? It's also a support and resistance area from the past. If you take a look at 23 January, pinpoints here and also picks it up here, matches with this thing, you have a direct entry to go long and pull out all your pips you can from this. Okay, not to mention it's a low area here, plus it's the low area of a previous day. Okay, this low area does not change. This is fixed because this day is done. This day's current day's MP might scale as the price moves. But you cannot change this one. This one's already set, right? So once you reach approximately this area and the market's hovering around here and you see that, okay, this is an area, it looks like we're going long. Boom. Yeah, everything. At the end of the day, the market will come back down to basics, and that is support and resistance. You know, I cannot express this strong enough. You know, SNR is very powerful in my terms. I know many people have different views on that, but as far as I'm concerned, as far as I've been trading, SNR is the way to go. Would you at least mention the importance of where to place the lines, where to place above the price in the and where? Okay, I'll get into that. Now, let's do this, like you said, Sanders. Let's do this one step at a time. How are we gonna do this? We're gonna remove our MP indicator for now. We wanna keep it clean, so you guys can see the charts. Everyone can see the charts now. Is it nice and clean? No issues there whatsoever. Okay, let's pick out another trade and let's see how it looks. All right, let's take a look here. What do you see here? The markets are going up. It creates a high, then it goes down, and then the high gets breached with this strong candle. Remember, when you have a strong candle, which it means a strong level of support and resistance has been broken. It does not mean markets are going long. It does not mean panic and freak out. No, it means a strong level has been broken. Okay, so you put your line here. This high has been breached here. Now, wait a minute. When you do the same thing here, the high never breached here. What's going on? You know, you have a totally opposite sense of scenario. Now, the markets were going up when this particular breach happened. We're going to connect our highs. We connect our highs to, let's say, this particular candle. Only one candle we connect it to. We don't know if it's going to go this high. And we connect it from here to here as well. And you're like, ah, okay. Markets are saying totally opposite things. Okay? We have a totally, we have a shift, a change in direction coming up. Yes, it's recorded. Don't worry. We have a change in direction coming up. Okay? So you're like, okay, since the change of direction is coming up, you want to be aware of where the drop is going to happen. Now, as the markets are moving, what happens? You get, first, you have an exhaustion. One of the first things I've taught in Urban Forex is the exhaustion pattern. Okay? You have an exhaustion sitting there and be like, look, I'm giving you a heads up. I want a short. Okay? Not only that, you have this opposite thing happening with your indicator, indicating the sense of direction once it changed. Now, you confirm this with your MP. Oh, great. Hold on. Let me get some more days on this MP. Hope it shows up. Yes, there we go. And what do you know? What is the lowest area? You see, when this happened, at this area, look how much activity was in the MP. It's really high. Really high activity. And you're like, okay, you know what? I'm going to wait a little bit. I know it wants to go short, but not quite yet. Wait. And then you start to see, as this exhaustion is formed, you start to see that MP starts to weaken. You find your area. You find your spot to short. Now, what is this area? Well, take a look at this zone here. Okay, you see how the MP starts to decrease here yesterday? Okay, let's go further back. Let's take a look. What is this area? Okay, support and resistance zones. You're going all the way as far back as you want. It's going to repeat itself again and again and again. Take a look at this zone. It carries the entire MP going into the low zone. Okay, and you can go as far back as you want. This thing will hold true again and again. Support resistance, if it holds true at one point, you go all the way far back, it's going to hold true everywhere. Okay? Look how precise it is. And so, you have this zone that tells you, okay, not only this is the right area to sell, we have an exhaustion. We have our MP getting weaker. It confirms with the past. Plus, we have this little opposite thing going on. I'm going to sell. Next candle comes along. You short. And boom. Now, what do you know about this short? Pop quiz. What do you know about this short? Okay. What can you tell me about this short? Small time trade? No. There is one strong piece of information. It's divergence? No. Tired? No. Next pivot? Okay, maybe, but no. Comes up from a trend? Also, no. Next obstacle like all? No. I'm going to explain to you guys. Take a look at this. Now, if we know we need to go short, right? We have this exhaustion and everything. We know we need to go short. Recently, how did we come up here to begin with? There you go, James. Big candle. It took a big candle. We broke a strong level of support and resistance somewhere to get up here to begin with. To go back down, we're going to fight that same level, which means big candle coming up. This is why you have this big candle. Okay? Remember, use what's in front of you. Don't ignore it. You know, this is a piece of information you need to see. A big candle is very valuable information. Okay? So it took you a strong level to break through this to get up here. And now the markets are telling you short. Well, if you want to go short, you better break through this level. And if you're breaking through this level, how many pips do you know do you have at least to grab? You're going to go at least past this area, right? This is a strong area that it broke through. You're going to go at least past down this area, more like 30, 35 pips is your guaranteed zone. You're going to get that regardless, no matter what. Everyone with me so far? Yeah, we continue. Next example. Okay, let's move on. Next example. And let's pick a different pair. Somebody give me a pair. Give me any pair you want. Euro yen. Okay, you guys like euro yen. Sanders, gold can be a little issue with this. Be careful on commodities with this. All right, let's take a look at euro yen. You guys really like euro yen, huh? All right, let's go back on on gold. Let's first remove our MP. Okay, so you guys can clearly see what I'm trying to explain. Okay, charts clear. Let's insert our indicator stochastics. I'm going to go to oscillators. I'm going to click on my stochastic. Standard settings, 533. Click OK. I'm not changing anything. I really don't care about the indicator. I can care less for the indicator. I don't like indicators. But I'm going to use this to see if there's something opposite happening. That's all. Okay, so now let's take a look at this one. Very nice example here. The market goes up, right? Reaches this high, comes down, boom, and then it starts to go up again, reaches this high. Now, while it's reaching this high, on our indicator side, we just breached our previous high, while in price, we did not. Let's take a look at this. You see how price, indicator breaks through the above this area? Everyone see this, how it breaks through? Now, if I draw my line on top of the price, we don't have that breakthrough. Now, if I were to even assume, okay, let's say, I'm just gonna wait, the price might break through. Well, for it to break through, you need 200 pips in your pocket to like jump that high. Are you expecting euro yen to make a 200 pip move in like a candle or two? Chances are slim, it's too far away, you know? So you have this little indication that, okay, now we have this opposite thing going on. Now, since the market was going long when this breach happened, we're gonna connect our highs. Okay, from this high to whatever the first breach is, let's say this one. You do the same thing on your indicator, from here to here. And you can see we have an opposite thing going on. This market's going down here, over here it's going up. You're like, voila, we have a shift in direction. Let's confirm that on this particular day with our MP. Let's see what MP has to tell us. When is the right time for us to take the sell? Let's open up MP. Let me add some days to this so it's there. Okay, you can see MP here on, it's really congested here, but let me move back maybe if that helps. No. It's really congested over here, up here, in this tip, okay? Let's take this area and be like, okay, if this seems to be the congested area, do we have any confirmation about this area from the past? Is this a level of support resistance? Let's scroll back and look. Well, big candle breaks here. We have some support here, okay? Big candle break, we have a little bit of resistance here, some support here, three candles in a row. Okay, anything beyond that? No. Okay, we have some sense of indication here, but you know one thing, that large candles are either stopping at this level or continuing, breaking out of these levels. Large candles, look at this one. Big candle here, big candle here, having a little tail come out here from the bottom and the top around this area. You know, there's strength, there is pushing up and down from this area. Okay? And then you have big candle breaches. So you know that this area is a strong level. Okay, with this strong level, next day opens up around this zone. If you were to enter your short, you have your short to go. Now, now for you to enter your short here, can you assume that you're gonna have a big candle at this point? Did we need a big candle to get up here? Okay. We it took us one big candle to get up here. Not to mention, this area we saw has support. Big candles stop from here and big candles begin from here. What the hell is this area? Put a line there. You're getting your big candle break. As you get your big candle break, take a look, two candles later, the market bounces off that area yet once again. Do not ignore support and resistance, guys. I cannot repeat this anymore. Do not ignore support resistance. Okay? You have this breach here. The markets are going down. Now, as it goes down, take a look at this. Take a look at this. As it goes down, now, did we breach below our recent low here? Did you go below our recent low here? Has the market gone below now? Everybody, did we breach below? Yes. Do we have that same scenario on our indicator? Did we breach below? Take a look over here. No, we didn't breach below our indicator area. The price did, indicator did not. Again, we have this opposite nonsense happening. Okay, let's clear out the screen. Let's get into this head on. Let me clear out MP. Move this out of the way. Okay, so what is this little nonsense that's happening with our indicators and everything? Let's take a look. Now the markets went down. We had our initial breach after this. We crossed through this on this candle. Okay, on this particular candle. If I move this down, oh, sorry, this particular candle. When I look down on this area, we don't have that same breach from our indicator from this area. Since we were going down, we're gonna connect our lows. I'm gonna connect this low to this current area. Okay, we have a low. Too low. From here, we're gonna connect our lows as well. We have a low to a high. Everyone agree? Opposite thing happening? Yeah? Indicating markets are looking to turn around in this particular case. Now, let's take a look. So, this is your first level of indications that those of you who are short, get out. Okay, risky trade now. Okay, first level of indication to exit. Okay, second thing, now that you have this, you're going to check this with your MP and see where is your area to enter. Okay, at this point, when this happened, how much strength is there on MP? Look at that. That's pretty big, right? When does MP actually get slimmed down? All the way down here in this area. This is the lowest point from this area till this part. The lowest point here and the lowest point here. So somewhere in here, you want to enter. As the markets approach here, you can see less and less strength in the market is coming in. Okay? So you are waiting and waiting and waiting. While you're waiting, you continue to see the markets are doing completely opposite things again and again and again. Because you can see from this low to this low, we went lower. But here, we went higher. The opposite stuff continues. You wait, you wait, you wait. And then finally, you check this area from the past. You're like, okay, now that we have some strength, what is this area down here? We're gonna check it from the past and see, do we have any connection from the past? Oh, do I have no more charts? Sorry, I have no more charts going back here. As you can see, I'm using VPN, so I can't get through. Big candle break, and we have resistance and we have support here. Okay, if you check this past on your screen, you'll see it. You'll see that it holds strength. All right, now, as the market comes back down and we go start to go long somewhere around this area, we decide we're gonna enter long. Okay, not here, but later on we enter long here. Okay, so we enter long here and we're going long. How did we get down here? It took a big candle to get down here. Now, another piece of information. Let's delete all this. How do I delete this? Okay. Another piece of information. As you're going long from here, level of caution right here in this range. Take a look at this. This was a powerful area which took a big candle to break through. You were not able to get that big candle break. How many candles does it take to make a big candle break? It takes one candle. This one candle touched that area, came back down, and closed. Don't risk it anymore. Close your trade. Yes, it's recorded, not to worry. Again, those of you who are watching this on YouTube, if you really, really like this webinar, please share it, like it, share me your feedback, everything. I'll definitely respond to you myself. All right. Everyone understanding the concept so far, how this stuff works? And you see how powerful this can be when you actually use it in conjunction with your MP. You can use it. You can use this concept with anything. I personally love to use this with support resistance. It's like mind-blowing, you know. Of course, even we have some professional traders in here like Sardar and Will Lee. You guys can also use this in your techniques. It's very, very helpful in understanding the trend, the market direction. So. And by the way, for those of you who are here tomorrow, we have one more webinar tomorrow for Sardar, and we have one more webinar for another professional trader, Will Lee. He's doing his webinar on supply and demand on the 21st of February. Okay, of course, they will all be recorded as well and be posted, but try to attend them live if you can. It'll be fun. It would have been easy to make an error in thinking that markets was going to go much longer, yes? Yes. Well, your first hint is when it actually tries to break through and it doesn't. That's your first hint to like just stop. You know, like you have enough pips already made there. You know, if you go from here, anywhere from here to here, this was 78 pips pushing through, and then it comes back down and crosses here. That's 50 pips right there, please. You know, 50 pips is sufficient, especially on one pair. If you're taking this on correlation on all the Japanese yen pairs and you're going long, 50 pips per pair puts you at 350 pips. You know, 350 pips is pretty good. You know, you don't need to like really cry about it. 350 pips is awesome. Okay. Terry, do you use this concept with your normal concepts? I use this concept totally differently. In my own ways, of course, slow and steady as I introduce more and more things to you guys, things will start to make sense. Like today, when I taught you guys this method, we used exhaustion candles, which is something we taught earlier. As we move forward in Urban Forex, I want to make sure that everything that you learn can be used with what you've learned in the past from us, because they all are interlinked. Okay, so we don't want to jump ahead of ourselves with anything. All right, so let's move on. Next pair, anyone give me a pair, we'll look at some examples. We'll look at a couple more examples, and then we'll call it a day. US dollar, Japanese yen? All right. Now, one thing, guys, for those of you guys who are looking to use this in correlation, use this in correlation only with currently the Japanese yen pairs. The US dollar is no longer correlating as strong as it is with Japanese yen pairs. Okay, Japanese yen pairs are taking over. When I say taking over, they're getting weak like crazy. So it's the Japanese yen pairs that has the most strength right now. So another one more thing I want to tell you guys is this is the time for you to not increase your lot size. And why I'm saying that, and I mean this in a very serious way, guys, is if you've noticed, the majority of the people, the human psychology is, like for example, in real estate, prices are rising. Everyone gets into real estate. They buy for 100,000. They make the money doubles. and then they spend additional money and they get another house, they flip it, they flip it. They keep doing this until it gets to the point where the market actually crashes and all gone in a single shot. Okay, now in the markets, okay, the big operators are pretty much starting these the year with nice trends and swings, giving you guys easy profit to make. Okay, remember, the profit you guys are making now in the last few months is chump change. It's nothing, okay, compared to what the real profit is available in Forex. As you do this, you're going to get greedier and greedier, thinking that you know how this works, and you're going to keep increasing your lot sizes. Coming end February into March, markets will start going range bound. As they start going range bound, everybody starts losing money left and right. So take my advice on this, and don't take my advice, take my opinion on this, and do not increase your lot size. Stay steady and ride it through. Okay? Can everyone repeat in the chat room saying, I will stay steady and not increase my lot size? Good, good, good. All right. All right, now let's continue here. Let's take a look at the next pair. You guys were saying what, US dollar, Japanese yen? Pound? Good, good. Good to see a lot of you guys are here and really attentive. It's a good crowd today. All right, all right, you guys were saying what, sounds like Forex Anonymous. All right, US dollar, Japanese yen, right? And pound. I think we might even have time for pound. In fact, pound, let's take a look at pound first today. We had a nice trade in pound. We had Forex watchers made tons of money on pound today, and I want to show you this. Okay, pound. All right, let's take a look at pound, yeah? What do we know about pound? Let's first delete our MP. We're going to just take a look at today to begin with. Insert, indicators, oscillators. I'm going to go to stochastics. There we go. Yeah, I'm going to go through the entry again. So I insert my pound. And now here's one thing I'm looking at with pound. Pound, we go high, then we go low, then higher, we breach higher. Our initial breach right here. Boom, first breach. That's not the case down here. We have another breach. It's not the case down here. You're gonna start connecting your highs. You're gonna see, okay. All right, we're still going high. Markets nonstop going low. Everyone see the opposites? Yeah. Next thing, we're gonna pop in our MP. Okay, my MP is plotted now. As we pop in our MP, let me remove all these lines so you guys can see. Sorry. Man, there we go. I think that should do it. No. Ah. Okay. There we go. All right, as we have this thing, our initial breach happens here on this candle when the day starts. As the day moves on, we reach a new high around here, and we see that our low area on MP is up here. Now, in case you don't reach that area, okay? In case you don't reach that area, and you're assuming that the area that the market opened is the best area because this is also the high of yesterday. You know, so you put your line here on the breach and you're like, okay, this seems to be the perfect area. You go further back to test this area. Let me remove this other line. I am really bad at removing lines. There we go. Okay. We go further back and see, okay, what is this damn line that we've drawn? You know, does it have any significance? Well, does this look like significance to you guys? Where we have resistance and support and a big candle break? Damn right, it's a good significance. It's perfect. It doesn't get any better. Okay? One big candle break plus a resistance, and we have support. This area is strong. Market goes around this area, it drops. Those of you who missed, market gave you chance number two. Because even when it goes up the second time, your indicator's not going up at all. It's still headed downwards while your price was trending upwards. Market drops. Why does it drop? Because by the time you reach this area, there's this big candle here that it took to go long. And if you put your area here, and you're assuming that, okay, the market's gonna go down here. If it halts here, I will stop my trading. How many candles does it take to make a big candle? One. And in one shot, it sliced through it. You were able to hold your trade, and this trade itself produced 120 pips, single pair. Yeah? Yeah, Sanders, that is correct. So now, just like Sanders said, this is it's very easy to look back and say, guys, this is what's going to happen. It's very it can be very easy for me to go into the past and say that, I see the markets, over here you should have gone long, over here you should have gone short. It's very easy to say that, right? Does everyone agree? It's easier to say that from the past when you look at the past, and it's different when you see it live. Yeah? Now let's take a look at here. This is my forecast from Forex Watchers before the day started today. Sweet, huh? So, when you actually do this live, now we actually have a group here for MP. We have a group here for MP. And for example, if any of you guys like the forecast, don't worry, it's available on forexwatchers.com now for free. There's no charge for it. Go into there. We're gonna start reviewing everybody on Forex Watchers, all the big forecasters in the industry. We're gonna bring them in, have them share their techniques. We're gonna do whatever we can to train you guys, to teach you guys how to see. Education is everyone's right, really. Come on. So now let's go back and let's take a look. Now the market's actually dropped, and here's what you're gonna do. We have this group here on the market profile group on Urban Forex. You guys can simply join this market profile group. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna update this every day. Practice it live, and like you guys are saying, it's different when you guys see this live. Okay, we're here to help you regardless. Come try it out live, take screenshots, we'll tell you what's different, what's wrong, I'll be there myself. So, I'm here on Urban Forex most of the time. We have some other professional traders here always ready to help you out. Remember, everyone has their own opinion. Make your own decision. At the end of the day, it's up to you. Okay. Yaha, you can simply just go to urbanforex.com, and on the homepage, I show you here on the left, you will see simply the group that says market profile here towards the middle. You just simply click on that and click join group. It's free, don't worry. No charge or anything. Can it be said, Pedja, you can watch this on YouTube. It's going to be available on YouTube. I'll give you the YouTube link. Okay, questions now. Can it be said that one giant candle will reverse in the next? No. You have to see the giant candle, how it responds to your support and resistance levels. Remember, the giant candle represents one thing and one thing only. Is a level of support or resistance has been broken. Okay? Now, repeat this to yourself, write it on your walls, tattoo it on your arm. I don't care what you do. That's the only answer to it. a strong level has been broken. It does not mean there's a good news, there's a news announcement. Forget the news. It's a strong level of support resistance has been broken. And that resistance and support resistance level will come back and recheck that level, or retest, if you want to call it. Okay? Now, the next thing, oh yeah, sorry, I wanted to show you guys, if you guys do want that forecast that you see, it's on forexwatchers.com. And you guys will all get it there. Also on Urban Forex, towards the top left, you will see all the, it's here, daily Forex forecast. You'll get them all here. Now also on Urban Forex, you will see we have webinars tomorrow. How many of you guys are actually here for the webinar tomorrow that Sardar is presenting? He has some excellent analysis that he does as well. And he's gonna present it tomorrow. Okay, there's a lot of you guys, good, good. And also the following week, we have Mr. Will Lee. Also, he's a great guy from Urban Forex, lots of fans. Also, he's going to be presenting on next Thursday on the 21st. And he will be presenting supply and demand, which is very powerful also. And I wouldn't recommend missing that as well. So thank you all for attending today. I hope to see you guys on our groups on Urban Forex. Thank you so much all for the support that you guys have given us, and look forward to making Urban Forex the best community out there. So thanks guys, have a wonderful night.